Hello, everybody. It's Circuit Man here, and we are on the last episode of 2016, episode 244 of the Brony Show. And of course, I'm here to bring you everything that has come out in the Brony community for Christmas. And boy, did a lot of stuff come out. But before we get into brass tacks, as it were, let's get a big warm welcome and hello to our panelists that are here right now. Fortunately, Blanked Mind is not able to join us at this moment as he is dead to the world. Unfortunately, he has fallen quite asleep. It's been a really busy, rigorous Christmas for him as well. So he is quite asleep. However, we do got a great panel here to join me in shenanigans all over. Starting off with, of course, from the Otaku Ascended, our favorite otaku, Suki.
You're squid. Yeah, I got Splatoon for Christmas, so.
Yes, he is playing with the Squid Sisters now.
Whenever my Wi-Fi likes to work with me.
And also joining us, we have the two familiar jump-ins that everybody should know and love at this point. If you're following the episodes, we also have Silent Blast.
Hello.
And some weird robot that keeps disconnecting on us.
Kid the bells, sweet silver bells, all seem to say, throw kids away.
Actually,
gone to the bed.
And our robot friend is glitching again.
Yeah, already, isn't it? In any case, we're here to bring you not one but 2 weeks worth of Brony content because it's holidays, it's Christmas. Well, it was Christmas, but it is at the same time. Because if you're any part of any kind of government institution, because Christmas fell on a Sunday, they're still celebrating it today, so we might as well do so as well. I am not kidding.
Yeah, I got to be one of the people that worked today.
I got to telework today at home. Nobody called. All I did was play Hyrule Warriors and Disgaea 3. It was fun.
It's like either third or fourth night.
We're already losing Toa there. Oh, and we just lost Silent. Well, any case, let me go ahead and give a heads up on what we're going to be doing today. We are going to be goofing around. He's trying. But yes, we are going to be playing the Twilight Sparkle Secret Shipfic Folder game on Tabletop Simulator. Of course, we're doing this because it's holidays and it's time to relax, enjoy, have fun, and what's better way to have fun than to pair a bunch of people together? Because we can't.
Wait, you mean like we can't actually put them together, or that we fail at socially attracting the opposite gender anyway?
Yes. No, I'm kidding. I'm that's a terrible joke. But in all honesty, I figured it'd be fun to put a bunch of people together for the holidays and come up with crazy reasons for it and see how quickly we can make the board a complete mess.
Yeah, it's not like I have anything to do today.
Okay. Of course, we do have Silent, Toa, and Suki joining in. Hopefully, we will get a couple of others to join in as well because this is a game that is best played with multiple people and lots of insanity.
Well, is Skyriz on? Let's see if he is.
Well, while you're getting into that, let's jump in a little bit here. And what better way than to warm up our vocal cords and talk about our holidays with What's Up Bronies? So, what's up, Bronies?
I'm doing well. So far I haven't got even a penny so I can't get Phantom Pain. So
no Phantom Pain for you, huh?
Nah.
Anything good though?
It's just clothes.
Yeah. That sucks. What? I almost died. let's see. Okay, so yeah, yesterday it decided to do the Christmas miracle thing and a blanket of snow fell in Utah. There was 3 inches by the time I woke up from nothing. We went from 0 to 3 overnight. So I wake up and there is literally a pile of snow in our patio. So I give it about an hour or so, hoping that some of the plows can go through. Of course, it's Sunday and Christmas, so it's not likely to happen all that well. And then after a while, I decide to try my luck and go out and say hello to my family for Christmas. I got stuck in our driveway. Of course, I got a little bit of help getting out.
Stuck on the road.
I got stuck in a ditch trying to leave my driveway. So not only was I stuck in the driveway, I was stuck with the ass end of my car in the middle of a road that is actually used pretty often. So yeah, that was fun. Any case,
I'm guessing out where you live, you don't have chains.
I usually don't. No, I admit I probably should get some, but usually when snow comes, sometimes we get some big snow waves, but usually it happens either when I'm at work, or it happens late in the night, so the plows usually have a chance to get through things before I do. So this was a unique experience to me. So yeah, I ended up getting out of the ditch and still tried to make my way to my family. And thus began about 45 minutes of driving on really slick, snow-packed roads, swerving over endless collisions, trying really, really hard not to stop at stoplights, begging that I don't have to stop at stoplights because my car wheels are not getting any traction on anything. I basically made a round trip to my parents' house, gave up, and came back home. Because there was no place to park when I even got there. They were about as bad as we were, and if I parked in there, I would have never gotten out.
And thus begins the pains.
Yeah, so I went back home, and instead I visited them later today for Christmas salutations, of course. But instead, I sat at home and watched Super Dragon Ball and got through every single episode that they have out so far. And it's fun. I'm enjoying the anime. Admittedly, it does have its flaws, but it really had some interesting storylines. And I'm echoing really badly on silent.
I don't know how it's doing that since I have the mic away from the earbuds. But other than that, now you have to continue JoJo's Bizarre Adventure.
Finished it earlier today. Hello? No! Wait, am I still here? Am I still live? Okay, I think I'm still here. Okay, yeah, I think Discord itself exploded on me.
He's gone.
There we go. No, Discord froze. Discord, the chat in Discord froze.
Huh.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, that happened.
I mentioned I finished JoJo 2 earlier today.
Yeah, but Skyro says he can do it up until 10.
Well, then, 10 what? I don't know what his time zone is.
2 hours from now.
So he's central.
Oh, well, that shouldn't be a problem. We usually wrap things up like that around 10 central anyway. Or close to it. Any case, that was my holiday shenanigans. I did take advantage of a lot of sales that are going on right now. I picked up Hyperdimension Neptunia V, which is like the latest iteration of it. Dishonored 2, the Angry Video Game Nerd Game 2, the second one. I can't think of anything else right off the top of my head, though I'm pretty sure I also got the Square Enix software bundle for me and for Cody. That ended up being a complete larf and sad little thing.
What was it?
Let's see. It had Final Fantasy XIII 3 Lightning Returns. It had the Hitman Go game. It had Legacy of Kain, both Soul Reaver and Legacy of Kain, the other one. Those two. It had the first episode of their Hitman, the latest episodic one that they came out with. Just the first episode, though, and some coupons if you wanted to buy the whole thing. And some weird game I never even heard about before.
What's the name?
I can't remember it. I'll have to look it up.
Yep. Let's see.
That was annoying.
Yeah. Well, let's see. So I was given Splatoon. I got into that, and when my Wi-Fi decided to work with me, yeah, I had a lot of fun with the game. Basically, it got to the point where yes, I have literally gone to Amazon and ordered an Ethernet adapter for the Wii U.
Nice.
And I had to do it on Amazon because nowhere around me sold anything like it.
Huh. Not even GameStop?
No. Okay. In fact, here's the thing. I went to the GameStop by where I work because I did go to work today, and I asked her about it, and she was like, she was just like, wait, they make that?
I have to admit, I did not expect to hear that it existed too. So I'm as shocked as she was.
Yeah. Wait. Well, here's the thing. Then I call the guy. Then I call the GameStop. Makes
sense, though. Let me kind of recount what I said about the GameStop. I should have just expected that reaction.
Here's the thing. Then I called the GameStop that I normally go to, and I asked about that. I said, hey, you know, I was trying to get a Wii U LAN adapter, and he goes, unfortunately, we don't stock any, man. So he knew what I was talking about.
Because the Wii U has kind of has a bad internet connection, like Mike's.
I don't know. My Wii U isn't too bad on internet.
It's based off of Wi-Fi. I know I have bad Wi-Fi.
It's one of those things you can't really help, you know.
Could it just be a router?
It's also the modem, and basically it's a combination of things. One, the Wi-Fi is not that great to begin with, and two, my Wii U is pretty much located right in the outer range of its of where it gets effective.
Ugh.
So, and for most of the time with the Wii U, that's not a problem. But of course, then I finally get a game that actually focuses a lot on the online. So yeah, that's coming in the mail, and I realized I should have just sprung for the 2-day shipping. It was like $3 more.
Don't you have Amazon Prime?
Yes, I do. For now.
Guess what?
That was with Amazon Prime. You can get 2-day shipping, and no, it's not free.
Well, that's stupid. Well, isn't that
did my Prime run out? My Prime probably did run out. That's probably what happened.
Yeah, I mean, that's the whole thing that they always tout with Prime. Get free 2-day shipping if you subscribe to Prime. It's like,
okay, what? Yeah, I think my Prime ran out. Never mind.
No.
Anyway, so that was one thing. Since I was out looking around for stuff anyway today, I went ahead and pulled a trick that I know you, Circuit, you said you'd mentioned it worked before, and I decided to finally test it out.
I did?
And yeah, a while ago I even asked you what equipment you were talking about for it, and you never answered me. It was talking about the whole HDMI trick, about being able to do it without having to go to the AV cords for like a PS3 and stuff like that.
Oh, you mean to record off of a PS3 and PS4?
The splitter trick.
Yeah, that splitter. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I remember I literally sent you a message like right after that conversation. You never responded to me.
I probably never got that message. That's weird.
but I went out today and I finally just said screw it because I went ahead and got a cheap one and did that, and I tested it with my Xbox One, and yep, it worked.
Sweet.
Because although it's funny, it's kind of weird. The Xbox One, even though it's got it technically has HDCP in there. Like, I can watch Netflix through my Elgato just fine. I can watch WB Network through my Elgato just fine. It's just that when I put in a Blu-ray, that's when suddenly it triggers.
No, I had the same weirdness happen with PS3 at some point, I believe.
But yeah, I got that. PS2, yeah, but I got that, so...
I think that's just a security thing. It is a
security feature, but at the same time, it's a really stupid security feature because most of the time, people just want to share it and not record it.
Yeah, but
they're punishing the many for the acts of a few.
Yeah. So let's see. So it was that. I know there was something else I was gonna bring up. What the hell was it? Oh yeah. I started and almost finished another anime last night, and it's actually one that I don't feel bad about recommending to people.
What?
I'm sure a lot of people know about it already, but it's called Usagi Drop.
I heard about it.
Yeah, it basically if you're having a bad day and you just want to feel better, or you're just in the mood for something that's just going to be, it's that slice of life and is pretty much built on, good feelings and things like that. You'd watch this show. It's very interesting. It's about a guy who's, very successful, like, sales manager, whose grandfather passes away. His grandfather had an illegitimate child very recently, to where she's only, like, 6 years old. And the mother pretty much ended up abandoning her, so the grandfather was raising her. But after meeting her and, like, spending, like, the initial weekend, the main character ends up taking her in. And so it's this whole thing about, like, essentially him getting used to the idea of basically being a parent, of, like, kind of coming into it. And it is a really touching show, and I'm definitely very much enjoying it.
It's kind of odd, though, that someone is raising their younger.
Yeah, it's basically his aunt.
Well, that does remind.
You can't pull.
Hello? Oh, I think we already losing.
I said you can't pull that stuff over my.
He's dying! Alright, well,
just because I'm getting music so you can play it in the back of Tabletop Simulator.
Fair enough. Alright, just real fast here, though. There is a couple of things that...
No.
I forgot to mention a few things, actually. Unless you wanted to jump in, Silent.
I was about to say, for the music, we probably shouldn't do that, because remember, since the Brony Show stuff goes up on YouTube, copyright strikes.
Well, only actual recorded music. I think it's going for more Brony content, I hope.
I am. I'm on...
Yeah, that
Equestria Daily, looking at the media tab.
We should be okay with that, but we should try to acknowledge artists if we can, of course. Anyway, before I forget, there is something that is coming that I forgot. I actually did have a few other things that happened before Christmas. One thing is, I'm part of a retro gaming group that here in Utah, and I went to my first Christmas party with them. It's a Secret Santa party over at a guy's house. It was crazy because I got to see all of these consoles and games that he has, and oh man, it's amazing what this guy's collection looks like. It is ridiculous. He's got four arcade cabinets in his basement, and one of them is a Nintendo arcade cabinet, which is ridiculously hard, which is pretty hard to find, and pretty awesome. In any case, we did a Secret Santa, and I actually got a gift out of it because, Secret Santa. I ended up getting a really, a pretty rare RPG, and it's completely blanking it because I can't believe I'm blanking it because I love this RPG. Illusion of Gaia. Illusion of Gaia on SNES. And I also got a USB Super Nintendo controller. And what that means is I'm going to be able to do a lot more with both the Brony Show, my Let's Plays, just in general, because a USB Super Nintendo controller is a godsend in some cases.
For being authentic playing Nintendo Super Nintendo game.
Nintendo, Super Nintendo, a lot of the emulated consoles, as well as user-created mod games. And even some Flash games and things like that would work a lot better with a controller as opposed to... using a 360 controller, which has the most horrible D-pad known to mankind.
It's not that bad.
It's that bad.
This is coming from a person who whose actual first console was the Xbox.
It's that bad. I played a Nintendo, Super Nintendo, Genesis, N64. I'm excited for that. That's for sure. And I also got a Pony Kinda Christmas gift box. And this one, unfortunately, I was a little disappointed in. It came with a holiday comic, which ended up being the holiday annual 2015, which we already did a review on, and the Applejack micro comic, just combined into one thing. It had us a pretty cool shirt. I'm happy with that. I got a blind box that had Spike, which I already have a Spike. So now I got two Funko blind little Spike figures. Couple of window clings, which is pretty cool, and the physical sound Pony Kinda Christmas soundtrack, so I'm happy for that. And also got a bunch of just general stuff, a few pizza gift cards, sweater, etc., and so on and so forth. And just a little quick thing on anime on Super Dragon Ball. I was cracking up laughing last night when I was watching the last few episodes that they recently came out with. One of them had a baseball tournament between Universe 6 and 7. And Yamcha was involved with this. Because he actually plays baseball. He ends up making the only run in that entire game. Because they basically leveled the field because Tempers flared and they blow everything up. And his hand is on home because he snuck in, stole it. And he is lying in the exact same position when he got blown up by the Cybermen in Z. And it's even more hilarious because everybody's looking at this. Doesn't that pose look familiar to you? Didn't he do that before? They actually referenced it, and it was hilarious.
Wasn't Dragon Ball Super the reason actually poked fun of the Super Saiyan names for each levels?
A little bit, yeah.
So, yeah, of course they're going to make fun of Yamcha.
I know, they are going to make fun of Yamcha, but you know, it was just hilarious that Yamcha was the victor, but apparently they made a joke about the whole pose, too.
Yeah, but technically, at like the end of the Z, Yamcha plays baseball professionally. If memory serves correct.
He does play baseball professionally. That's also why I thought it was pretty funny that they did include him in that, and he was actually the one that actually knew what he was doing and actually succeeded. Any case, we kind of delved a little bit too much into this, but, you know, there was a lot to talk about. We, you know, everybody had a pretty big Christmas. Anybody else want to chime in on this real fast?
Oh, yeah. Thank God, Attack on Titan Season 2 is coming soon. Other than that, I saw something earlier today that kind of made my smile go to ear to ear. Apparently, we're getting an animated Captain Underpants movie.
You didn't know about that?
No, I did not know.
I've heard rumors they've been looking into that for like a year now.
Yeah, apparently DreamWorks is doing it.
I only know Captain Underpants vaguely, and that's about it. I don't know anything else about them.
Oh, yeah. I guess speaking of movies, I did manage to see Rogue One over the weekend.
Oh, yeah. Did you? Were you as melancholy at the end as I was?
To be perfectly honest, I figured that. I figured they were going to pull that with the ending, because, I mean, think about it. You know what? Wait, I'm trying to figure out if I should say anything, because...
I mean, I should probably avoid it.
I don't know, because, I mean, we're... Because with Star Wars, it's like, what's the thing on it? It's like, what, at least until it's out of theaters?
I don't know. That one, I give it about a month or two, really, on at least trying to avoid spoilers at all costs. And they may be lightly allude.
Yeah, but basically, it's one of those things where you know something about the ending of the movie
Guys,
is going to happen.
We don't have to spoil it. What we gotta do is look at the beginning of A New Hope, and then...
Yeah, I know. I know. It's obvious what probably happened.
Yeah.
Yeah, I get it. It's obvious what probably happened, but it's still kind of melancholy in a weird way.
Yeah, I mean, it was still done well. It's just one of those things where it's like, you know, I knew what ending was coming because there was basically one big question that when you ask it, you realize, right, that just means they'll do this.
All right. Any case, let's not go too much into that.
Alone this year, so yay.
Sweet. All right. Anybody else have anything they want to throw out there, or should we go ahead and finally give people a chance to breathe and not get spoiled?
Yeah, let's go. All
right then.
Suki, to answer my question, just private message the answer.
Oh, yeah. All right. Well, let's see. You go ahead and move on to news circuit. I'm gonna go get some water.
Sounds good. All right, let's go ahead and get into it. We do got some show notes here, and we are going to run through the news as quickly as possible, because personally, I really want to get into ship fic bouldering and all that. So first off, Fallout Equestria. A lot of you know about this, and some of you would probably be interested in getting a print copy of the book. They've already done two runs so far. I managed to grab some copies of my own on the second run, I believe. Now they are doing a third run of the book. It looks like they were able to this time around combine both books. Previously, I actually had to buy two books. They were shipped together, but it was like part one, part two. And they combined into one book, but if you are interested in getting a printed copy of Fallout Equestria so you can have it permanently, even if the internet explodes, it's available to you. You just need to fill out a form, go to our notes, or just go look up Fallout Equestria book or on Google or something like that. And it looks like they're selling them for about $45, and shipping is going to be free in the U.S., but... $25 in Canada and $35 everywhere else if you're not in the U.S.
Wow, and Hasbro, is the creator Chinese? Because I'm just saying.
What do you mean?
You would think Hasbro would just say, no, you're not. You can have the fan fiction, but you're not monetizing this.
They can't do anything about it, in all honesty. This falls under, This actually falls under creative content 100%. Yes, they took the concept of ponies, and they allude to what happened to the main six in Equestria, but they never actually outright say it. And they don't actually use any of the characters in My Little Pony. They use their own created characters.
Yeah.
If anything, Bethesda probably has a better chance of ripping onto this than Hasbro ever does. But that's just from what experience and knowledge I have regarding this. But yeah, it's completely legal. There's nothing wrong with it. And if you like the stories, I say go for it, because, you know, a copy of a book, why not? I doubt they're making any money off of it, really. Or barely any money off of it. You know, books are pretty expensive to print nowadays.
Study print, yeah, it's mostly E.
Yes, it's mostly E. All right, now next, there is a horror game called The Fall of Anterfold, which has recently been announced and a beta released. This is a horror game, apparently. I don't know too much about it. I just barely found out about the game myself earlier today and downloaded the beta that they have out, so we'll probably be end up playing that on the Brony Share at some point in the future. But yes, you can see from the picture here, you are in control of a pony. Of course, you are in a dark and scary place with a tent and poles. All right, let's see. Here's a little bit of information on it. Fall of Anterfold is a hardcore survival game where all have own rules. Yeah, somebody needs to proofread that. Rules of each chapters will be different. Okay, I think this person's language, first language, is not English.
Typos everywhere.
No, it's very English. It's not typos, it's English. The grammar is off. Only cooperative actions can help you to survive. One life, If you or your friend is die, game will end. Random rules. Every star equal new rule. For example, in first star, you have a good drop of items and little amount of creatures. In second, you have no items and big amount of creatures. Danger of fight. Every next battle with creatures can be fatal. You will need to think to your head. Own universe. Fall of Answerfold has own storyline and universe, which too can be expanded by other players. Game's still in beta, but you can help with bugs and ideas. All this you can leave on official site and forum. During the beta, game can be changed many times. So,
Circuit, I have one question.
Yes?
Does Bruno Mars is gay?
Unfortunately, I saw that coming. I saw that coming, and I couldn't come up with a good response. So I'm pretty sure that the whoever created this, English is not their first language, but otherwise the game is interesting in concept, where it's basically survival horror, and every time you play, it's a different experience. So we'll probably be playing the beta here at some point in the near future on the Brony Show, so stay tuned to that. If you are curious about it, though, the notes have a link to the beta, so you can try it out for yourself. Now, here's a little bit of other English. Canada has apparently got a new Princess Luna plushie. And this is literally the equivalent of Tacked On.
So it's a beautiful Duang.
Well, let's see here. Well, this one's a little bit difficult to say. They got the basically the streamer butt thing going on, but the wings are quite literally tacked on.
Streamer butt with a vengeance.
Like artificial wing. Basically, they Twilight winged it. They just got a staple gun. Ka-chunk, ka-chunk.
Done.
Like it literally looks like that joke. Like it looks like a joke what some people would did back when the whole everybody gets wings thing, where it's like literally just some paper wings that they stapled on.
Yeah, pretty much. It kind of does look like that. All right, Cole is asking, what do I think of a PMV like that? I think I'm actually going to be playing that on the stream here for one of the videos near the end. So, I think I'm going to play it. That's pretty much all I can say there.
I'm just saying we're probably going to have to start making like movie titles for the streamer butts because we keep seeing more and more. We have
actually we barely seen any for a long time until the last couple of weeks.
Yeah, it's starting to they're going to start returning. So stream harder.
All right. Now if you're in Russia, it looks like augmented reality is coming to your coloring book. My Little Pony augmented reality book is showing up, and apparently it's going to be where you can put your phone up to the coloring book and it will actually show little 3D displays as is augmented reality.
Hooray! Pay us $15 for it.
Yeah. I am still somewhat curious about it, and I would like to try it, but unfortunately they've only been announced in Russia.
And you can't read Czechnik, can you?
And that's not the problem. It's a coloring book. I don't need to worry about reading it. And the import would be ridiculous. All right, moving on. United Kingdom. Actually, that is correct. The UK, England, European magazine that does ponies from time to time has announced their new latest figure. And it's going to be Flurry Heart. It's a little tiny pony baby figure for the next one.
Am I the only one that thinks that her face looks like somebody punched it in?
It kind of does.
Just the picture they took. It just looks bad, but no, it literally looks to me like she just got she got punched square in the between the eyes. Like she got punched so hard the top half of her head is folding in.
It looks like she was like in like a UFC fight.
No, she's a victim of the latest trend on YouTube, baby punching. Punch babies.
Because, I mean, God, look at that. Her cheeks.
Who dropped the baby?
Look at that. Her cheeks and her and like her mouth and stuff are literally all just coming out, but the rest of her head is just flat from where it starts.
Yeah. I'm hoping that it doesn't look quite that crazy when we actually see the figure, but it does look pretty bad.
She was punched by Conor McGregor, but other than that, I kind of want to see you crush your girl's flurry heart now.
No, I don't. Moving on. All right, holiday Aurora plushies have apparently shown up in Hallmark stores. Of course, the holidays are basically all but over at this point, so if you are intending to pick one up, I would recommend trying to find one at a Hallmark store or start Googling around for it. But they're pretty cool, though. It got Pinkie Pie and Rainbow Dash with a Santa hat and scarf. Well, slightly colored off Santa hat and scarf, but still, really nice.
DM12, you kind of got that wrong. Because, yeah, it's making baby noises, but it was always no kick the baby.
Kick the baby.
Kick the baby.
All right, now who's ready for My Little Brony dolls? Again.
Did they make more of them, or there's just something going on with the original ones?
There's something going on with the originals, namely the Pinkie Pie and Fluttershy ones have been released. Of course, the Pinkie Pie one is the one that I honestly, I'm just, all I can do is look at it, and I don't know where the mindset was for this.
Okie dokie lokie, bro.
My face is an internally cringing permanently kind of meme right now. I'm cringing so hard. Oh, God.
Yeah, I mean, just pink curly hair, the hat, the tank top with Pinkie Pie on it. I don't know.
Okay, to be perfectly honest, if it wasn't for the hat, this thing would be okay.
Yeah, the hat just kind of kills it.
Like the hat.
Oh no! It's worse. He's got a tattoo on his thigh.
Oh,
well, his cap
that's
actually.
His cap,
but he's still got a tattoo.
The tat in the hat put it on cringe overload for me.
And suddenly I'm just thinking of some weird parody book that somebody's got to create. The tat in the hat.
Because I mean the whole hair coloring thing, I mean that doesn't really bother me. I mean, whatever.
No, it's just the accumulation of all of it. It just,
I do not like this doll, I say. I do not like it.
Well, it is what it is. But Fluttershy also came out, and in all honesty, I think they kind of overdid Fluttershy in a whole different way with this one.
I think they literally just used a Barbie doll.
I wouldn't be surprised by that. Just a Barbie doll put on some gown and a t-shirt and just like, yeah.
I mean, I'll be perfectly honest. Honestly, if it wasn't just straight up a picture of Fluttershy on the top, this isn't too bad of an outfit.
Yeah. With even with the flower crown.
Actually, I think even with the Fluttershy at top is still pretty good. Heck, if I had a girlfriend that dressed like that, I'd be just like, okay, I'm good. We'll go with them. Yeah.
There's no need to complain.
I'm not complaining here. I actually endorse this 100%. So, yeah, Fluttershy actually, it takes it a whole different way than Pinkie Pie, but in a way I can't complain with. But then again, I can complain about anything if I really want to. I'm old enough. I don't care anymore. Anyway, moving on. Let's go into actual pony figures instead of brony figures. Here we have the Twisty Twirly Pony Brushables. And these have appeared on Entertainment Earth as of last week. Essentially, it looks like ponies with dreads.
So basically, so Pinkie Pie already just got hair tips from Wooly.
No. No, Pinkie Pie went down into Jamaica, man. She got herself a few spliffs and then she got reliant. Just had to get herself some good cornrows. Oh, man, that stuff was so way dope.
Oh, man, so wait. So this means all we have to do is just get them a hat and suddenly we can have our own pony anchor on MTV News.
Oh, yes, we can.
I I feel like you and I are the only ones.
I'm in the coconut because you've had too much.
Circuit, I get the feeling you and I are the only ones who remember that, dude.
No, I remember.
I saw screenshots, unfortunately. I got off of MTV about the time they got off of music videos.
Yeah.
They still have music videos. It's only whenever nobody's watching.
Yeah.
So pretty much all the time now.
Remember when MTV had actually good things to put on? Alright, excuse me.
Let's go ahead and move on before we start sounding like pretty much like half the internet. Moving on! Nesting pony dolls. Who's here? Who here has heard of nesting dolls?
I always knew them as the Russian name for them.
Yeah.
What is it, Matryoshka?
They have always been Russian nesting dolls for me.
I've just known Russian nesting dolls, but I know what they are at least. But yes,
I wish I could remember what the actual name is, but I've always heard the actual Russian name for him, but I just can't think of it right now for some reason.
Mm. Well, in a fun little twist, we now got My Little Pony nesting dolls. These are going to be coming from PPW Toys in mid-January for $17, and you can pre-order them now, and they are actually pretty decent sized.
Well, until you get to the small one.
Well, yeah, but that's the whole point there. So yeah, if you are interested in getting your own set of nesting pony dolls, now you have a chance. And thus, the term they're ponifying everything is still quite applicable. So, who's ready for Rarity's Runway? Too bad we're getting it.
Get him. Is it ready for takeoff?
No, but it's ready for a fashion show, apparently. So you can go ahead and put ponies onto a runway that they are going to be releasing, and you just slide them back and forth.
Wait a minute, sir. Rarity kind of looks like one of those chicks from Grease, just with like some stupid sunglasses on.
Tell me more. Was a love at first sight? Okay. Yeah, I see that now. Oh man, I'm not sure that's hilarious or terrible. But yes, apparently it's not only Rarity that is going to be getting onto the fashion runway. It looks like Rainbow Dash is also going to be doing her strut down the. Rainbow Dash is going to be dressing in style as well. Of course, it's with the very familiar Grand Galloping Gala dress.
All right, and it was about the Marie Antoinette dress. That would actually be kind of funny.
Yeah, but where's the fun in that? And finally, in books, Trixie and the Razzle Dazzle Ruse has officially been given a book cover. It's pretty much
Seth is happy.
Yeah, Sethisto from Equestria Daily is certainly happy. I kind of like it. It's a little on the generic side, but that's all it needs to be, really. Now, as for what the book will contain, we'll have to find out when it releases. And if I ever read it. And in any case, that is it for merchandise news. We do got quite a bit of other things here. Starting off with Season 6, Part 2 of My Little Pony is now on Netflix. So the latest 13 episodes leading up all the way to the Season 6 finale are now available completely on Netflix. All the way from 1 to 6 now. And oddly enough, they changed all cider references in Season 6 to juice.
Wait, in all regions?
In all regions.
What?
Yeah, apparently, where the apple lies on Netflix, even the American Netflix, they have it changed to juice instead of cider.
That's just dumb.
Yeah. Yeah.
For the love of God, parents in all cultures, come on. For crying out loud, have more faith in your kids to know the difference between fantasy and reality.
Well, if anything, it makes it so that the jokes we have with Rainbow Dash.
Some kids at age 12 can drink in some countries.
Yeah, unfortunately, this obviously this is just because paranoia. Everybody's out to sue me. I do. It's kind of stupid. Actually, it's incredibly stupid. Hopefully, it's just Netflix that's doing it. I don't know if the iTunes digital releases are going to be changed, and I don't know if the DVDs for season 6, when they come out, and we know they are going to be holding the same change as well. It could just be a Netflix decision, which really still sucks, but it is.
Yeah. I mean, and I guess in a way, it's just so that way they don't have to release a different version for all the regions. They can just put the same one out.
Yeah. And I know that the whole point is just, their cider is supposed to be non-alcoholic, but it really makes for a lot of great jokes. Especially when they change it to juice. Now we've just got the big joke. They're drinking juice. Remember, it's apple juice.
Come on, everybody. Let's get some Jesus juice.
Okay, what I missed.
Andy, are you getting drunk? No, Ma. I'm drinking juice. All right.
To be fair, though, the BS song did go from Speedy Side of Squeezy 6000.
Yeah. Well, that was even more hilarious because he basically got a bunch of ponies chanting cider, 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 cider. Yeah. Any case, for those of you who love the comics, first off, the Micro Comics Series 4 have officially been released. Of course, these contain about 4 of them, each with a small version of the different Friends Forever comics. Also includes a poster and a sticker sheet, which is always really fun to have. A little poster, a comic, sticker sheet. How could you say no to that?
Maybe decorate your laptop.
There you go. Decorate your laptop. Sorry.
That too.
Caught my throat there. But yeah, they have officially been released, so keep an eye out on them because they tend to go pretty fast if you even see them. Also, speaking of comics, MLP issue 49 has officially been released. This one is a continuation of Accord, Discord's organized other half. Now, of course, we're not going to talk too much about it because it's pretty much mid-arc at this point. Everything is pretty spoilery. But yes, you got the main six dealing with Discord, who has officially flipped and is now a being of pure organization instead of chaos. Of course, the funny thing is, I actually did pick up this comic when I was over at my local hobby shop over at the mall during the holidays, and I didn't realize I was mid-arc, so I get one page in, I'm just like, ah, crap.
I spoiled myself.
Well, kind of. I only just saw one page, and I didn't spoil too much of it, but at the same time, it's like, ah, crap, now I gotta get the earlier comic, or else I'm gonna be mid-arc, and I won't know what the hell's going on.
And Circuit Troop, I would have thought that he would also go through an appearance change if he's gonna be pure order.
Well, kind of yes, kind of no. He looks a little more organized, but he still looks like Discord at the same time.
Yeah, well, vaguely, I don't know. I get the feeling Discord's regular self would be more akin to Calvin Ball.
The fuck is a Calvin Ball?
It's a joke that you Philistines who didn't grow up with Bill Watterson will never know.
Calvin and Hobbes.
I know of Calvin Ball.
Oh, okay. Sorry, Vega. We were kind of talking about I guess the fact that Discord was, changed into another being, so he was like, regular Discord. Okay. Yeah. But yeah, the problem is I didn't.
Yeah, Accord's been kind of his fan, so it's just been confirmed.
And My Little Pony Friends Forever with Luna and Celestia.
Yep. My Little Pony Friends Forever 38 has been announced. Of course, this is an exclusive to Equestria Daily, so thank you, Equestria Daily, for letting us know and not getting at us for using your articles to let other people know. Fronts Forever 38. A minor squabble between Celestia and Luna turns major, and the two decide they need some time apart. When they divide Canterlot Castle between the two of them, will the leaders of Equestria find a way to live harmoniously again? So basically, the two sisters get squabbly.
So basically, they're doing the college roommate thing.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, I mean they even do the joke on the old on the trope with this where you got the, like, on the one cover you got the dotted line going down the castle.
Yep. The other one, it literally shows them breaking Canterlot in half, which is a little bit more aggressive, but still kind of funny.
Oh, I didn't know Luna's pet was a mouse.
It's a possum. It's the awesome possum. But yeah.
What is his actual name? It's a. She calls it.
Oh, he's an opa.
Tibble? Was it Tibble?
I don't recall, actually.
I forget what she named him. I think it was something like that.
Dignity name starts with an R, I believe.
Alright. Okay, so moving on here into the next comic. Issue 52 has been announced as well. Now this one, we're going to just show the covers and allude to a little bit because admittedly, I'm not sure if some of this is spoiler territory for Season 7. Because this the comic actually ties into Season 7. For those of you who ever said that the comics are not canon, we told you they were soft canon! Anyway. So yes, it involves the a new villain apparently. Of course, Season 7, of course they're going to have a new villain. It's supposed to delve a little bit more into the origins and information about this villain as opposed to when they encounter him at the beginning, or at least, that's what I got. I can't really give out too much more than that because it's kind of getting brushy there. So enjoy the cover art and pick this one up when it comes out. Moving on.
So Unicorn Kylo Ren.
Unicorn Ren. Actually, we don't know. He might not be the same what we think. Don't judge oddly enough, I can't believe I'm gonna say this. Don't judge a comic book by its cover.
Even though that's the entire point behind the covers of comic books.
Yeah. Okay, so there is a new My Little Pony deviation that is going to be released. Let's see. Anyway, there's a deviation for in the month of March. I'm not exactly sure. It's a one shot. Okay, this is a one shot deviation that they are making for March. Of course, you can see right there what this is going to involve with, but it does involve Blue Blood. Of course, one of the other comics are one of the ones I'm going to be interested in because it has Judge Pinky.
She is the law.
I am the law!
Yeah, Blue Blood's getting them all the bitches.
Yeah. So, the quick synopsis on this one. In the world where Prince Blueblood becomes Celestia's star pupil, not Twilight Sparkle, what will happen when he journeys to Ponyville to get a lesson in friendship? So this is
He gets that ass times five.
So he is literally in a what if scenario.
Which is funny because there's, God, I have not checked in on this author in a while, but there's a guy that pretty much made up an entire universe where, Blue Blood gets sent to Ponyville instead of Twilight, but they change it up to where the main six are stallions instead of, mares.
Oh.
And they all still hate him.
Well, yeah. If anything, I kind of like the whole idea of mares. You literally have a self-conceited stallion trying to hook up with five ponies in order to save Equestria, but at the same time, he's probably not exactly trying to go for that alone. Any case, that comic is coming out in March. And finally, Friends Forever, issue 35 has officially been released this week. This one involves the Twilight Sparkle and Starlight Glimmer. Or Sunset Shimmer. I'm sorry.
The more teachers.
No, that's Starlight Glimmer.
Oh wait. Oh, it was Clam Clam. Jeez, why did I get that? I was doing so well. But yes, the issue combines both of them as they go to the. Well, quick synopsis. I actually read this. They decide to tidy up the castle of the two sisters, which unfortunately starts to turn dangerous as they awaken something evil and mysterious. Some of you that are interested in giant ponies might have an interest in this comic arc, in this comic story, by the way. Leave that alone. But yeah, it's an interesting read. I actually enjoyed it, and I think people should give it a shot. And yeah, the cover makes her look sinister as hell, but it is good fun and friendship and all that jazz. So, moving on, the Tales of Equestria book RPG that we've mentioned several times, we now have more information. Starting off with the core book itself will be a 152-page full-covered hardbook with apparently the back cover also telling you how to do a book RPG if you've never done it before. And again, anyway, they're giving you the idea of what the hell you're going to be doing with this. Along with that, they've also released pictures of the first set, which is going to be the Curse of the Statuettes, which we have mentioned before. The contents include an adventure book, a GM screen, 6 polyhedral dice, and character sheets. And you can see them all right there. Which is also a little disappointing because I won't be able to use these in my own campaigns here because mine are online. But along with that, they are going to be releasing a tokens of friendship, basically gem tokens that you can use in the game as well as a separate item. Basically, it's a bunch of purple chunk rocks things in a box and a bag.
And the Twilight Sparkle color too.
Yep. Now, the funny thing is that they've also released what the pony sheet or character sheet is going to look like. And to be honest, it's not all that surprising, considering that this is not supposed to be a really highly detailed, insane book RPG. This is not Rifts, this isn't Dungeons & Dragons, and it is definitely not Pathfinder. So, it's pretty simple. From what you can tell, they have some quirks, they have a cutie mark, they have a talent, body, mind, charm, stamina, and also name, level, and etc. so on and so forth.
Somebody will still make these available to print somewhere online. When you use the couple that come in the box and you're just like, shit.
That's why you always keep one.
Or you could just scan it in and then print it out.
Or you take one over to a copy store and just go ham on it. Need 100 copies of this.
Don't ask why.
No, we just say 100 copies. You can ask why, we'll advertise it. You can join our group. Yeah. So yeah, the character sheet though, it looks pretty simple, so at least you know, if anybody wants to try it out, it's not going to be a all-day process. I've actually had a book RPG sessions where you'd spend an entire day getting it together, and it's insane.
Yeah.
All right, now this, unfortunately, is something that we are going to have to say something about because it's starting to affect a lot of different communities, including the Brony community. Mainly a changing of YouTube algorithms as well as how they're advertising and promoting their content is changing. And because of that, a lot of long-standing YouTube personalities are starting to see a massive dip in viewers. Unfortunately, because of that, some groups have unfortunately had to change to other options or stop doing what they're doing. One of them is Silly Philly Studios, who brought us Snowdrop and Fall of the Crystal Empire, as well as Donut Steel, who is the greatest action hero of all time.
But everybody on the YouTube channel, please hit that like, subscribe, and comment.
Like, subscribe, comment, hit the little bell. Do what you can to let people know about it. At the same time, I'm not monetizing on this, so it's not exactly a detriment if I start losing viewers, though I would like to get more viewers because it means that people are enjoying my shtick.
Well, here's some things that have been pointed out. One, if you're a content creator, sometimes it is now very, very much based on what you tag your video with. Number two, if you are viewing the video and you want that video to get viewed by other people, watch the video all the way through. That's actually affecting it.
Yep.
If you like the video, watch it. Because if YouTube notices that people are just watching part of the video and then just backing off, they're not thinking that people want to watch that video. That's actually a part of the algorithm.
Unfortunately, it is. In fact, a lot of the algorithm switches that if you look into the channel information, it counts on minutes viewed as opposed to times viewed. So they're counting to minutes at this point.
Yeah, they changed that.
Yeah.
Well, they've gone to longer format because look at like YouTube Red and their format.
Well, we're not going to delve too much into what might be going on. To be honest, there's tons of videos about this. I honestly recommend Game Theory. They do an interesting perspective on it. Definitely check out...
sister channel, Film Theory.
Yep. Also check out Silly Philly Studios for their thoughts on the whole thing and what they might be trying to do in this future. There's also thoughts coming from pretty much everybody, really. A lot of people are starting to voice out and give their thoughts and opinions. Unfortunately, PewDiePie also became... I basically lost any and all respect I ever had for him, which wasn't very much to begin with, but that's a whole nother case. So, yeah, it's just, unfortunately, a really sad moment because we always had such great animations to look forward to, and... Well, we'll still always have the ones that they did make. Those are always going to be there for us as long as we back them up and other people upload them if something goes wrong. But they were there for us, and now, you know, no, we're not going to get anything else from them. So it's really a sad moment. Yeah. Of course, I've also heard a few people are looking into other different avenues. Of course, that also means that I found out about a couple of other video sites that would have been really nice to know before I moved all of our archives, or started moving our archives over to Vimeo, but I guess it can't be helped now. Anywho, let's get back on track here. We're getting a little bit on the soft side. We do got a few fan submissions and suggestions to throw out here real fast. Our challenge of the week was ponies in hockey. Unfortunately, let me double check. Maybe I did get a submission that I might have forgot about.
Mike did do it.
Mike did give one, yes. Mike. Yeah, I'm thinking about somebody else, yes. Though. But Mike, we definitely got one, so we'll throw that out here real fast. Mike Nice did throw out his submission here, ponies in hockey. And it's, of course, Applejack and Rainbow Dash. Now, this one, I'm going to give him a lot of credit because he knows nothing about hockey. He came into this completely blind. So, he ended up setting it up, learning how hockey is played to some extent. And we got a nice little face-off between Rainbow Dash and Applejack. So even if this is the only... we do got another one. We got another one from... I think it's Dr. Jer. I forgot what we call him now. Mine just suddenly blanked. I feel terrible. Dr. Bristle! It's Dr. Bristle! Yes, Dr. Bristle also threw one out there. And...
Oh, the doc.
Good old Bristle, yeah. So, Dr. Bristle also has one, and it is true to his style in every way. We see, I believe those are actually self-created of Terrence and Philip. I think that's Ticker that's in the background as well. Or it looks like it anyway. Of course, we also see his constant referencing to True Capitalist Radio and Ghost. Actually, the funny thing is that Ghost apparently got a ponified version of himself, and he started and he promised to sell an autographed versions of it if he managed to get a pre-orders for over 200 or 300 of them. So that was kind of messed up in a way. Anyway, but yeah, we got True Capitalist Radio, and we also got Applejack with a hockey stick. I'm pretty sure that he got that from somebody else's art. I'm not gonna lie about it. Yeah, here we go. Mysterious Chaos came out with the Applejack, but he cobbled it all together. So yeah, Dr. Bristle gives us another little bit of silly art right there. And of course, yeah, what are you gonna do? So I was also brought into suggestion about what we could do for our next challenge of the week, ponies and Darth Vader. Unfortunately, I forgot that somebody emailed that to me, so I came up with a different topic because I was trying to think quickly. So we'll probably hold ponies and Darth Vader until next week. This week's challenge is said ponies and memories. The reason I'm doing that is we are nearing the end of 2016, and despite all the crap, there has been some good that has happened in 2016. So, you know, sometimes it's good to just still sit down and reflect on the good things that have happened as opposed to all the stupid messed up crap. In any case, that's enough of that little bit of sidling there. One last little bit. Carol of the Bronies. A bunch of Brony analysts have come together once again. This time, each of them are released a recording on their own channels where they sang a Christmas carol. Dr. Wolf, Firebrand, Silver Quill, Dusty Cat. A lot of names that you already know and love, I think. Too bad I'm not in there. Why can't I be known and loved? Why can't I be one of the big boys? I can wear the big boy pants.
You're old.
Ow!
People don't like old.
Ow! Dusty Cat's older than I am, I think. No, Silver Quill. He's in his 40s. Come on. Ow.
To be fair, he is newer than you in the Brony scene.
Everybody's newer than me. I've been here since mid-season one. Oh, well, never mind that. We're okay. Enough of that crap.